Welcome back to the channel. I want to give an update on using scene cut detection. I had a couple commenters have a little trouble with getting it to work or where to find it. So let me jump in and show you. Scene cut detection works on your media before you bring it into a bin in your media pool. So let's make a new folder down here in our media bin, and I'll just call this Back to the Future Cut. And I'm going to choose that folder as a destination. As you can see, it's empty. Now, if we're navigating through where our media storage is, we can right click, and down here we have the scene cut detection option. So we click that, and then you have this little graph, and it's showing you green where it thinks it has a cut. And you can click over here on the right hand side and kind of navigate through. And then what the little thumbnail pictures are is the preceding frame, the frame you're on, and then on the right is the frame after. So if we go back down here and go to this cut, you can see you actually have to be here to navigate the individual frames, but we can go through and play. We can kind of speed through. So this lets you sort of quality check how well the scene cut is actually doing. I had one earlier right here that wasn't an actual cut. If we zoom in a little bit, that's what this little line in the middle is. You can raise it above and below. So anything green is a cut, and then anything grayed out, it's not going to make an actual cut in the little EDL, as it were. So if I hit play, we can see there's a cut there. So I'm going to lower this line to where this turns green. And now I'm saying, yes, that's a cut. And I just made sort of a smaller in and out. So I didn't do the whole thing, but just this little section here. So if that was the whole thing, you would make sure everything looks pretty good. You could navigate through here and check your cuts. And if you need to cut one, you hit this little scissor here. And then you add this button or click it. It says add cuts to media pool. So I clicked that. It did it behind this screen. So we're going to X out of that. And now in our destination directory, we have individual clips down here. Now there's two things you could do. You can go to the edit page and just dump them on in, or you can grab everything. So if I select and control A, and you can say create new timeline with selected clips and just click it. It'll ask you for a name. I'll call it Back to the Future Cuts. Here's the timeline it just made. And now if we go to the edit page, we've now got our cuts lined out. So that's how you can get scene cut detection to work. It only works on the media page up in your media storage. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys on the next video.